Hello everybody, Narcissist Free Almost here, and today I want to focus on morality and its correlate basic human decency as it pertains to the pathological narcissist. But first, a few definitions. So we have morality, which is defined according to the Oxford Dictionary as principles concerning the distinction between right and wrong or good and bad behavior. Also, the extent to which an action is right or wrong. Digging a little deeper, there is moral decency, which is defined as polite, moral, and honest behavior and attitudes that show respect for other people. Lastly is basic human decency, which is considered honesty, good manners, and respect for other people. But over time, decency has referred to manners, but today decency is mainly a strong sense of right and wrong and a high standard of honesty. Next, I'm going to jump to the narcissist development, or rather lack thereof, and their inability to understand such abstract concepts. Since most of us here know that the narcissist is developmentally stunted, we also know that there's so much more that goes into this other than understanding that the narcissist possesses a psyche of a 2-year-old. People who've been following my vlog know that I talk a lot about manic defenses and where I believe all psychopathology begins. Manic defenses are basically 3 psychological processes: control, contempt, and triumph, and begin in early infancy when the infant is faced with conflict. At this point, the infant must make a choice between reparation, which is the healthy choice, and promote psychological growth, or destruction, which would be the use of manic defenses, which obviously stunt growth, leaving the child forever grasping for feelings of omnipotence, instead of facing the pain of mourning. In other words, the infant begins a cycle of behavior that will either encourage whole and healthy growth that includes all the growing pains such as dealing with loss and all the emotions that go with that, or choose to avoid psychological pain and maintain the infant stance where they're the center of the universe and everyone else is there to meet their needs. The later choice is incredibly destructive, and why manic defenses are named the destructive choice. This will affect the person's psychological growth, leading to cluster B personality disorders. What I just said here is very simplified and can get very complicated going forward, though I've made a few videos on manic defenses, and you're welcome to watch those if you're interested. That said, when manic defenses are activated and allowed to be the infant's preferred method of dealing with conflict, eventually they will become unconscious and be the preferred method of dealing with conflict in adult life, and we know them as your pathological narcissist. Now that control, contempt, and triumph are running the show, all other psychological processes will be stunted or not developed at all, such as empathy, the ability to reason, object permanence, and so on. Furthermore, such abstract concepts like morality and decency will be twisted in meaning to the pathological narcissist. Of course, a narcissist will profess to be of the highest moral character because they do know the difference between right and wrong, and that's pretty black and white, right? Pun intended. Morality to a narcissist might look like a perfect credit score, tithing if they go to church, and being a stellar law-abiding citizen. This class of morality is ideal for the narcissist because it's straightforward and public. Everyone sees it and will make judgments about such things. Following these rules definitely fits into their superiority and grandiosity. That is, they are so much better than everyone else, and especially when they're comparing themselves to others, which is what they always do. However, that's not to say that narcissists don't break the law. They certainly do. In fact, skirting laws, such as cheating on their taxes or screwing people out of money through one scheme or another, wouldn't bother them at all as long as they don't get caught. They've done nothing wrong. Even if they do get caught, it's not their fault. You know the routine. Anyway, my point is, that narcissists don't care about being moral. They just care about feeling superior. And by following a certain set of rules that makes them better than everyone else, well, that's what they're gonna do. It's also a nice cover to get away with other things. People will never suspect them. They'll sit on their moral high horse and judge harshly, and do so without compassion or empathy for those who have veered off the straight and narrow or made some unfortunate mistakes. Remember, the narcissist's mantra is, it only matters what it looks like. It doesn't matter how it really is. Now, the reason I brought up the narcissist's developmental failures is because they are unable to distinguish the subtleties of morality, just the black and white of it. For example, how many narcissists are decent people? To me, a decent person doesn't spread rumors to ruin someone they don't like, or participate in malicious gossip just to make themselves feel better. Nor does a decent person pretend to be parent of the year, yet never show up for school functions. A decent person wouldn't pretend to be someone's friend just to get information on them to use against them later. A decent person wouldn't keep blaming someone for something they never did, nor use another person as a punching bag to relieve themselves of tensions from the day. I think you get the picture. So when it comes to basic human decency, the narcissist fails miserably. And they would, wouldn't they? Considering that they're operating from a false self, that is, a persona that was created to gain as much attention, accolades, approval, affirmation as possible, the entire concept of decency would be missed. In other words, the false self is going to be as efficient and go for as much supply as it can with the least amount of effort, whereas decency is an internalized set of rules that requires thought, empathy, and compassion. You need to ask yourself questions like, well, I'm going to treat people the way I want to be treated, and I wouldn't like that done to me, so I'm not going to do it to someone else, or what is the right thing to do, not the easy thing to do. Finally, next time you're trying to spot a narcissist, especially using moral standards, keep its correlate of decency in mind. Most pathological narcissists will look exceptional on paper. If you think about it, it's a very efficient way to gain the most amount of supply and perceived respect. And this will sidetrack you, thinking this person is respectable, responsible, honest, etc. And to an extent, part of that is true. Or is it just another way for the narcissist to look and feel superior, judge others, and take advantage of others while no one is looking? I think looking for decency in others might be your best bet. Again, does the person do the right thing or the easy thing, especially when no one's looking? Or do they treat others the way they want to be treated? Watching for the subtle yet most important distinction to assess whether or not you should be in a relationship with them or not could mean the difference between being with a decent, honest, compassionate person or a pathological narcissist. With all of that said, I think the quality about decency that sticks out the most for me is honesty. And we all know this automatically disqualifies a narcissist. That and the fact that we all learn this stuff by kindergarten. And if the person you're with, whether it be a friend, a coworker, or a partner, doesn't practice this by now, the truth is they're never going to. And if they're never going to, they don't respect you. And if they don't respect you, you can't trust them. And if you can't trust them, what's the point? Anyway, one last thing. Happy New Year, everyone. And I do hope this year you'll all be living peace of mind, narcissist free. Thank you.